الحمد لله على إنعامه، والشكر له على تفضله وامتنانه، ولا إله إلا الله تعظيما لشأنه، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وإخوانه. أما بعد، Today's khutbah is a reminder of a binding agreement, a covenant that we entered into with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, this covenant, this binding agreement, has been dishonored and broken by many. Allah Azza wa Jal, before us, He took this covenant from Bani Israel. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And remember when we took a covenant from the children of Israel, saying, worship none but Allah and be dutiful and good to parents. This is Allah's advice and Allah's covenant that has been dishonored by many amongst human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us again and again about this agreement. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ. And we have enjoined on man to be dutiful and kind to his parents. His mother bore him in weakness and hardship upon weakness and hardship. And his weaning, meaning his breastfeeding, is in 2 years. And Allah emphasizes this again. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهًا وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ 30 شَهْرًا. And we have enjoined on man to be dutiful and kind to his parents. His mother bears him in hardship, with hardship, and she brings him forth with hardship. And the bearing of him and the breastfeeding of him is 30 months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions that this is one of the characteristics of the greatest messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Yahya ibn Zakariya alayhi salam. Allah says that he was dutiful to his parents. وَكَانَ تَقِيًّا. And he was righteous. وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَيْهِ. And dutiful towards his parents. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ جَبَّارًا عَصِيًّا. And neither was he arrogant nor disobedient. And likewise, the other messenger, that was his cousin, Ibn al-Khala, Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam. Listen to what he says. وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا. And dutiful to my mother, and made me not arrogant and disobedient. As for your messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though he grew up as an orphan, and he did not enjoy in his lifetime the company of his parents, nevertheless, he was dutiful to them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after he had signed the Treaty of Hudaybiyah and he was on his way back to Medina, he stops at a place known as Al-Abwa. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he takes leave from the rest of the army and he goes into a secluded place and he spends moments, and after some time he comes back to the Sahaba and his face has changed, and behold, his beard is dripping wet with his tears. What happened? Why did the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam become so emotional? And he said to the Sahaba that he had asked permission from Allah to seek forgiveness for his mother, but permission was denied. And therefore he asked permission to visit her grave, and Allah Azza wa Jalla permitted him to visit his mother's grave. When we speak about mother, We speak about love. We speak from the heart to the heart. We speak about recognizing and rendering good to the most deserving human being. The merciful mother, the compassionate mother that carried us in her womb and gave birth after she had suffered for such a long time, and she almost sacrificed her life when she was giving birth. A man came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he said, من أحق الناس بحسن صحابتي? Who is the most deserving human being of my kindness? And the Messenger of Allah says, أمك, your mother. قال ثم من? He says, who next? And the Messenger says, أمك, your mother. قال ثم من? A third time again, the Messenger says, أمك, your mother. And then the fourth time, when he said, ثم من? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Abuk, your father. Allah Azza wa Jalla has given her three times more rights than the father. Why? Because she occupies a very lofty place in Islam. Allah has recognized her superiority. And when you look at events in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you realize how much this was emphasized upon. A man came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and is seeking permission to go for jihad with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now, in Islam, jihad occupies a very special place in Islam. Why? Because it is an act of sacrifice. A human being is called upon to sacrifice his life, his wealth, sacrifice his very existence on the face of this earth. And that is why it occupies the pinnacle of Islam. But the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he turns to this man and he wants to teach him that in Islam there could be perhaps something that is even more greater than jihad, more honorable than jihad, that has more ajr than jihad. So he says to him, Alaka Umm, is your mother still alive? And the man says, Na'am. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Ilzam rijlaha fathamma al-jannah. Go back and stick to her feet. That is where you will find your Jannah. Obedience and kindness, lowering the wing of humility, speaking to her in respectful terms. Your mother, never ever raise your voice to her. Never ever speak to her in harsh terms. One of the Sahaba came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He had left his village and he came to Medina, making hijrah to be with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he says, Ya Rasulallah, ji'tu ubayi'uk. I came to pledge my allegiance to you. Wa taraktu abawaya yabkiyan. And I left my two parents in tears. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, without any hesitation, irji' alayhima wa adhikhuma kama abkaytahuma. Go back to them and put happiness on their face the same way that you brought tears to their eyes. Being kind to your mother is one of the easiest ways of getting rid of sins, removing mountains of sins. One of the Sahaba, he came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he made a confession. He says, Ya Rasulallah, لقد أذنبت ذنبا عظيما. O Messenger of Allah, I have committed a major sin. And when one of the Sahaba describes a sin as a major sin, then you should know without any doubt it is a major sin. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to him, ألك أم؟ Do you have a mother? He says, لا. She's no longer alive. And he says, ألك خالة؟ Is your mother's sister still alive? قال نعم. قال فبرها إذن. Go back and treat her with kindness. If this amazing thing, it extends from the mother to the mother's sister, how about the mother herself? الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he goes up his minbar one day, and every step that he takes, he says Ameen. And when he was asked what he was whispering about, and he said that he made a supplication, Jibreel عليه السلام made a supplication, and to each one he answered Ameen, and he stated, رغم أنفه من أدرك أبويه أو أحدهما ولم يدخلاه الجنة. In Arabic, رغم أنفه means, may that person be humiliated, may that person be disgraced by Allah. Who is this person? The person who finds either both of their parents alive or at least one of them, and he does not enter Jannah through being kind to the parent. It is the easiest route to Jannah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one day he fell asleep, and in his sleep he saw a dream, and the dream of the messengers of Allah is a revelation from Allah. He sees in his dream that he has entered Jannah, and inside Jannah he can hear somebody reciting the Quran. And so the messenger of Allah, he asks, sawtu man hadha, whose voice is this? And he's answered, sawtu haritha, this is the voice of haritha. And the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, kadhalikumul birr, kadhalikumul birr, kadhalikumul birr. He earned this status because of his kindness to his mother. Three times. So what did he used to do? كان يفلي رأس أمه. He used to comb his mother's hair, and in case he finds anything like lice, he removes it. وكان يطعمها بيده. And he used to put food from his hand to her mouth. وكان يسقيها بيده. And he would give her water to drink with his own hand. وإذا تكلمت بكلام, and when she speaks to him and he hasn't heard what she said, he does not say to his mother, mother, what did you say? Repeat what you said. But rather he waits until after she has left. He says to the people around him, ماذا قالت أمي آنفا, what did my mother just say to me? عثمان بن عفان, he has an amazing testimony. He says, ما قدرت أن أتأمل وجه أمي منذ أن أسلمت. He says, ever since I became a Muslim, I have never looked straight in my mother's eye, in my mother's face. Abu Huraira Ali رضي الله عنه, before he leaves the house, he turns and he says to his mother, السلام عليك يا أمه ورحمة الله وبركاته, رحمك الله, رحمك الله كما ربيتيني صغيرة. May Allah's mercy and peace and blessings be upon you, my mother. May Allah have mercy on you the way you raised me when I was little. And she says to him, وعليك السلام يا ولدي ورحمة الله وبركاته, رحمك الله كما بررتني كبيرا. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you, my son. May Allah be kind to you the way you have shown me kindness in my old age. A man came to Al-Hasan, Al-Hasan al-Basri, the great tabi'i. And he says to Al-Hasan, he wants a fatwa. So he says to Al-Hasan that I have already performed the obligatory Hajj, and I have asked my mother for permission to perform another Hajj, and she gave me permission. So Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu wa rahimah, he knows of the man who came asking for permission after he made hijrah and he was told to go back. He knows of the man who asked for permission to go with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam for jihad and he was told to go back to his mother. So Al-Hasan says to this man, لَقَعْدَةٌ مَعَهَا عَلَى مَائِدَتِهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ حَجَّتِكَ. Sitting with your mother and sharing food with her, it is more beloved to Allah than your Hajj. Al-Hasan is the one who said, النَّظَرُ إِلَى وَجْهِ الْأُمِّ عِبَادَةٌ فَكَيْفَ بِرُّهَا. He says, looking at your mother's face is an act of ibadah, it's an act of worship. How about being kind to her? What can we say, my brothers, in this day and age when people have turned into even worse than animals? Because animals, they recognize the ones that gave birth to them. Human beings, شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ, something amazing and shocking. And that is why one of them, he said, أَبْنَاء قُلُوبُهُمْ أَقْسَى مِنَ الْحَجَرِ. Sons and daughters whose hearts are harder than rocks. وَأَلْفَاظُهُمْ أَحَرُّ مِنَ الْجَمْرِ. And their words, it burns more than fire. وَأَلْسِنَتُهُمْ أَحَدُّ مِنَ السَّيْفِ. And their tongues sharper than swords. This is a real life story that a man shared with me of a man that spent so much time with his wife and there's nothing wrong in doing so. But unfortunately, did not give any time to his mother. So his mother once complained to him, how comes you don't spend time with me? And the man got so angry and upset with his mother that he said to his mother, so you want me to spend time with you? Do you also want me to sleep with you? عِيَادًا بِاللَّهِ فَلَهُمْ مَثَلُ السَّوْءِ. To such people belongs the worst of examples. كَمَنْ لَعِقَ الثَّرَى مِنَ الظَّمَأِ. Like the person that was so thirsty to the point that he started licking the wet earth in order to quench his thirst. حَتَّى إِذَا وَجَدَ بِئْرًا. And finally he came across a well. شَرِبَ مِنْهَا حَتَّى ارْتَوَى. And he was able to quench his thirst. ثُمَّ الْتَوَى لِيَبُولَ عَلَيْهَا. And then he turns around to the well that quenched his thirst. And then he urinates inside that well. أَيْنَ هَذَا مِنْ قَوْلِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Where is this person from what Allah says in the Quran? هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. هَلْ نَسِيَ هَذَا وَأَمْثَالَهُ. Has this person and others like this one, have they forgotten سَهَرُ اللَّيْلِ. How the mother used to keep awake all night in order to nurse them, in order to breastfeed them, in order to change their diaper. And she stayed awake and sleepless when the child was sick. يَا وَيْلَ هَذَا مِنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ. Woe unto this one from the torment of Allah. Listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. كُلُّ الذُّنُوبِ يُؤَخِّرُ اللَّهُ مِنْهَا مَا شَاءَ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Every sin, Allah reserves the right to either punish it in this life or to delay it until the day of Qiyamah. إِلَّا عُقُوقُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ. Except disobedience to the two parents. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُعَجِّلُهُ لِصَاحِبِهِ قَبْلَ الْمَمَاتِ. Allah, He hastens it in this life before death. قال علي رضي الله عنه. Listen to what Ali said. فليعمل العاق ما شاء فلن يدخل الجنة. He says the person
that is disobedient, that is disrespectful to their parents, let them do whatever they want in terms of good deeds, they will never enter Jannah. That is what the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. So this is a reminder to me first, to you my brothers and sisters, because if everybody looks at themselves in the mirror, what do they see? يَرَوْنَ عَاقٍ. They see in the mirror a person that has fallen short of his obligation towards their parents. And my brothers, before it is too late, even the person that was cruel and undutiful to his mother, after she has died and Allah gives him hidayah and he becomes guided to the straight path, he becomes remorseful and his soul torments him and he wishes he could go to his mother's grave and ask her to just bring her head out and kiss her on the head and say, Ummahu samihini, oh my mother, forgive me. But it is too late. So before it is too late, may Allah make us of those ones who recognize that through the mother is the easiest path to Jannah. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى به ملائكته المسبحة بقدسه فقال آمرا ومخبرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وزد وأنعم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين اللهم فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم ارحم آباءنا اللهم ارحم آباءنا اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا اللهم إن كانوا أحياء فبارك لهم في حياتهم وإن كانوا قد ماتوا اللهم فاجعل قبورهم روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعلها حفرة من حفر النيران عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقم الصلاة